Good afternoon. I am Neeraj Bhadresa from ATP Engineering College. Today we are discuss about some important problem of function and limits. We already discussed some of the problem of the function and we already discussed some of the problem of limit. In the limit, we have concluded up to only how can we use or how can we solve our problem using rationalization. Today we are extend some of the rationalization problem again. So our next question, that is limit n tends to infinite under root of 4n square plus 2 minus under root of 2n square minus 1 divided by n plus 3. So we write it limit n tends to infinite under root of 4n square plus 2 minus under root of 2n square minus 1 divided by n plus 3. So here n tends to infinite type sum, so we must convert our sum into 1 upon n form, because of 1 upon n is equal to 0, and here square root, so we must remove the square root. So first step to remove the square root, that is nothing but take rationalization of, that is multiply and divide of numerator. So we first of all take a rationalization and then convert our this sum into 1 upon n form because of limit, that is n tends to infinite. So our first step, that is take a rationalization. So here square root of 4n square plus 2 minus square root of 2n square minus 1 divided by n plus 3, rationalization of numerator term, that is multiply and divide with square root of 4n square plus 2, here this minus sign become plus, and square root of 2n square minus 1. So here 2n square minus 1, so this value we want to also divide. So ultimately our sum, that is under root of 4n square plus 2 minus under root of 2n square minus 1, numerator becomes as it is. So here under root of 4n square plus 2, and here plus under root of 2n square minus 1. So if we take this term as a, and if we take this term as a b, so we call this term as a minus b, this term take as a, this term take as a b. So final value, that is a minus b, and this sign, that is multiplication sign, so again here a, and here plus sign and b. So we can write here a plus b here. So if a minus b into a plus b, so we can easily write a square minus b square. So we want to simplify this total numerator term into a square minus b square form. So here limit n tends to infinite a square, that is nothing but square root of 4n square plus 2 square. So we write here a first of all and then square, so here square minus sign as it is, and this minus sign also as it is, b square, so b value, that is square root of 2n square minus 1. So we can write here square root of 2n square minus 1, and answer, that is b square, so this is b and this is square, divide by this is n plus 3, so we write here n plus 3 as it is, and this term, that is 4n square plus 2 plus square root of 2n square minus 1, we can write here as it is. So our denominator becomes square root of 4n square plus 2 plus square root of 2n square minus 1. Now again we want to simplify this term. So for simplification of first step, that is simplify numerator, here square root and here square, so finally square root and square both are negligible. Here again square root and square, so finally we can neglect it. So remaining term, that is limit n tends to infinite, the square root and square cancel, so here only 4n square plus 2 minus, again square root and square cancel out, and remaining term, that is 2n square minus 1, we write denominator term as it is, that is divided by n plus 3, same value, square root of 4n square plus 2 plus square root of 2n square minus 1. Now again we want to simplify over this term. Here 4n square plus 2, this minus sign multiply with first term, and this minus sign multiply with second term. So if we simplify again our numerator, then the value becomes limit n tends to infinite, here 4n square plus 2 as it is minus 2n square, and this minus multiply with minus 1 becomes plus 1 divided by, here n plus 3 as it is, and we write total value denominator as it is, that is square root of 4n square plus 2 plus square root of 2n square minus 1. Now again we want to simplify numerator first, so our next step, that is here limit n tends to infinite as it is, here 4n square, here minus 2n square, so result term, that is only 2n square, 4 minus 2 becomes 2, here plus 2, here plus 1, so remaining term, that is 2 plus 1, that is 3, divided by n plus 3, write here as it is n plus 3. Now time to simplify numerator term, so that is here square root of 4n square plus 2, so if we want to take a common of n square, then here square root, we want to common n square, so first term contain only 4, because multiplication of n square into 4, that is total first term 4n square, plus if you want to take a common n square from second term, then we must divide with n square, so remaining term n square into 2 by n square is equal to 2. Same way, we want to take a common n square from our second term, that is square root of here n square, we want to take a common, so remaining term, that is only 2, minus sign as it is, and again we want to take a common n square from our second term, so we divide by n square, so finally n square into 1 upon n square becomes 1, so that is our second term. Now again we want to simplify our denominator, so here limit n tends to infinite as it is, here 2n square plus 3 as it is, divide by here n plus 3, we write it as it is, we want to take a outside of n square, that is under root of n square becomes n, so we write here only n, and remaining term, that is square root of 4 plus 2 upon n square, plus same way we want to outside the n square from square root side, So in second term, remaining term, that is here n and here 2 minus 1 upon n square. Now again time to simplify our denominator. So our next step, that is limit n tends to infinite. Limit n tends to infinite, 2n square plus 3 as it is, here n plus 3 as it is. Now just look at here n and here n. So first term and second term, both the term contain n. So time to take a common n from both the term. So if we take a common n from both the term, then remaining term, that is square root of 4 plus 2n square, here plus as it is, and here remaining term n, that is common out. So remaining term, that is square root of 2 minus 1 upon n square. Now next step, that is here maximum power of n, that is n square. So now time to divide all the term by n square, that is numerator and denominator we want to divide by n square. So here limit n tends to infinite, if we divide by n square, then 2n square divide by n square, resulting term, that is only 2, plus divide by n square, so here 3 divide by n square. Denominator term we want to total divide by n square, so first n square and this n, both are cancel out. So here remaining term, that is n plus 3 divide by n, and this term we write as it is 4 plus 2 upon n square plus square root of 2 minus 1 upon n square. Now again time to simplify this term. So here n plus 3 divide by n, so this n divide both this side. So again we want to simplify this denominator. So our next step, that is limit n tends to infinite, here 2 plus 3 upon n square as it is, this n, that is divide both the side, so n divide by n becomes 1, plus sign as it is, 3 divide by n as it is. Now write this term as it is, that is square root of 4 plus 2n square plus square root of 2 minus 1 upon n square. Now just look at our question, n tends to infinite, here all the n, that is in 1 upon n form, so here 1 upon n form, here 1 upon n form, here again 1 upon n form, here 1 upon n form. So it is time to put a limit to our sum. So that is when limit n tends to infinite, 1 upon n is equal to 0. So our aim, our question, that we convert into 1 upon n form here. So when limit n tends to infinite and 1 upon n is equal to 0, we can write 1 upon n square is equal to 0. We can also write 1 upon n cube is equal to 0. So using this equation we apply toward this sum. So finally we apply to limit and we want to simplify it first. So when limit n tends to infinite, 2 becomes as it is, so here numerator term contain only 2, this plus sign as it is, and 3 by n square when limit n tends to infinite, and our answer, that is 0. So here write 0, here 1 as it is, plus sign as it is, 3 by n, that is nothing but 1 upon n form, and answer, that is 0 in bracket. square root of 4 as it is, because no any n, but here 2 by n square, so ultimately this resulted becomes 0. So plus 0 plus sign as it is, here again square root, and 2 minus 1 upon n form, so this becomes 1 upon n equal to 0, so here 2 minus 0. When limit that is applied, we put equal to sign here. Now again time to simplify this sum, so here 2 plus 0, so we can write it equal to 2. 1 plus 0, write just 1. Square root of 4, write 2. Plus sign as it is, and again square root of 2, we can write it here. Now again time to simplify this sum, so here finally 2 divided by 2 plus square root of 2. So if we multiply and divide by with rationalization of denominator, then we can write here 2 minus square root of 2, same way 2 minus square root of 2. So finally we can got equal to 2 here, multiply with 2 minus square root of 2 divided by here 2 plus square root of 2 and 2 minus square root of 2. So this is nothing but a plus b. If you call a, that is 2, and if you call b, that is square root of 2 into a minus b. We can write here a square minus b square. So we can simplify 2 plus square root of 2 and 2 minus square root of 2, that is nothing but a square minus b square, that is under root of 2 square. Now time to simplify this sum, so equal to here 2